What is ventilation? Which everybody is clear. What? Why do we ventilate? Ventilation is exchange of air. Exchange of air. Like we ventilate all the time. We have got ventilation for homes. We do it for industrial purpose. And so on. Now what is it? One of the factors is just now you tune yourself to a typical home. Okay. If it is too hot, we open the windows, allow outside air to come in and replace the inside air. If it is too cold and outside is warm, we do the same thing, to either to heat or to cool down. Both ways we use it. That is ventilation at home. Then sometimes you go to a place where nothing, the room wasn't open for some time. That is stale air, odor is there. So you open the windows first. Get rid of the smell. Okay, odor has to go off. Another one is toxic gases. Now toxic gases I will compare more to when something is being fried at home. Sometimes there is a smoky thing, no? So what do? You keep exhaust on so that the smoky stuff, that oily thing is out and you get the fresh air coming in. And if any other reason, you just need to have a nice fresh air inside. Why? I have got home. Okay, I was busy working this, that, whatever it is. And outside, I have got nice fragrant flowers. So I opened the windows so that outside air comes in and enlightens my mood, right? This is all we have experienced in life. Now, theoretically, the best way to ventilate it was open everything and let allow everything free flow. But that is practically not possible, right? Because you can't break down the walls and all for ventilation. So what do? We have got windows. Same system follows. We have got windows for natural ventilation, right? Then, if you have got window air conditioners, if you have got window air conditioner, there is a setting outside air, right? And closed circulation. Suppose if you put in outside air, means outside air is blown in the room. That is with power, your ventilator is a mechanical ventilation. Then you have got another type of ventilation, what we have got in loos as well as in kitchens, exhaust fans. Exhaust fans repel things, means they throw it out. And that air gets replaced through the natural source, like a window is open or something and it comes in. Whereas there are also systems where you have got a small fan blowing all the time in to replace the air. That generally you find in offices and all. Okay, so in the end, what is it? Ventilation is a replacement process for the air inside the compartment with the fresh air. Now, since natural one has got limitation, you know, there is no breeze. So even if you keep windows open, it doesn't make any difference. So what we need is, in that case, you put the vertical axis vertical axis fan and try to blow something in. We do all sorts of things. Why? Because we get fed up of heat or cold. Now, same way, we need to deal with cargo compartments. Accommodation is just like home, so we have got a similar system. Cargo compartments also you need to ventilate for the same reason, to remove heat or remove excessive cold or humidity. It is excessively humid, so you want to remove humidity, odor, toxic gases. So there are many things which we need to do with the same process. And the consideration is one of the factors is involved, that is why we ventilate. Natural ventilation is without any force. It is just based on the whatever wind you get and it blows clear, fine. Mechanical ventilation means we, instead of using a natural source, we force it by using fans. Different types of fans for either to blow air in or to suck it out. Exhaust fan or inlet fan. Now, once upon a time, ships did not have so much of electricity and other things. So we used to have natural ventilators. That is this ship. It was opening like this and you adjusted it on vertical axis to face the wind. And opposite one, because hold will have four ventilators always. Minimum four ventilators on each hold. Okay. Top, forward two corners, aft two corners. That allows the air to go in and come out from other side. Okay. So now if you had, now you are not going to see them anyway, but have a look. These are cowl ventilators. That is, they were based on then wind flow. And they used to be closed. If weather is bad, then we had to put a canvas covers on it and so on. And this is something which moves on vertical axis. So that you can adjust the direction. And there used to be ropes tied and all, if bigger ones. Smaller ones you can go and catch and turn according to wind. So they used to be used once upon a time for cargo ventilation also, cowl ventilators. Like big mouth and then it's going in a pipe and it is going in the hole. Then came other ventilators which were with a blower inside. Okay. Now, this one doesn't have a blower inside, but it can be closed by closing the rotating this wheel. Underneath, there is a flap which will get closed, like just the water taps and all same way. This is mushroom ventilator. Okay, they come in all shapes and sizes. Then, this is another variation. Okay, let me see what is this. But others are seeing my screen, no? Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mrityunjay, your connectivity issues, okay? Don't worry. We record it. I always record it and I'll be putting it. So even if you miss something, it is a different story. Now, these are also mushroom ventilators. But what is the difference in the previous one and this? I'll show you. Previous one is just a ventilator. You leave it open. Or you can close it as you like. And process is natural. Hot air will rise and it will escape. And cold air will come from somewhere. These are similar mushroom ventilators. But the difference is, you see these boxes? These boxes are electric connections. And here, there are fans inside. Turbines, sort of. Electrically driven. So, it can take a suction and throw out the air from the compartment, or it can do other way around. Now, most of them are reversible. So, it's just a question of adjusting it, which way you want, to supply or exhaust. So, these are also same. Then you have got, this is the typical one. This is what we have got inside there. You know, this is the open one. And this is inserted here on vertical axis, here. So that you can blow or exhaust, one of the two things. Now, what happens is, another systems you must have seen, like what is central AC and all. So ships have got ventilation for living quarters also, obviously we live there. So that is through the ducting. There are ducts which supply you cold air. And there are ducts which are used for exhaust purpose. So that is how the whole accommodation is centrally climate controlled. Climate controlled because, using air conditioning is one way word. Yes, centralized systems are there. And that is what is done in the accommodation. Centralized systems. So they have got big ventilator. From there the suction takes place, then it is cooled down under AC and then it is sent to different ones And every cabin has got a climate controller. You adjust it what you like, what temperatures you like. But it is all done from one location. Now the same location handles air conditioning as well as heating. Because ships go from anything from minus 25 degrees to plus 45 degrees temperatures. So we worry about climate control. Climate control because humidity also must be maintained. How do we maintain humidity? There is a steam inlet. If you start heating air, it starts losing its humidity because the air gets heated up in cold climate. So we inject some steam also so that it maintains the humidity. That is how we look at it in this. Now what happens is, now in holds. Holds, like I told you, generally there will be four ventilators or else there will be ducting inside the hold also, depending on type of ship. Some ships will have ducting inside the hold also. Some ships have got very advanced systems which, because of specific cargoes, that is, they will control even humidity. It's a built-in systems, centralized for different purposes. Now, a lot of bulk carriers, like especially the ones like, you know, Tolani ships and all the smaller size bulk carriers, 80,000 tons, 70,000. They got natural ventilation. This is how the ventilator is fixed up in the hatch cover. That means you open this flap. It's like window. It's open. Air can go in. Air can come out. So that is natural ventilation. That is generally on a certain types of bulk carriers who do not have extensive requirement because the cargoes are of different nature. Whereas many ships will have a full-fledged mechanical ventilation system with fans and controls. Because it again depends on a cargo. Like if you carry specific type of cargoes, like including on a container ship, specific type of cargo, it cannot be loaded under deck. Unless you have got mechanical ventilators. Okay. And then there are different sets of rules. If you have got mechanical ventilators, it's allowed. If you don't have, because once we had that issue in Europe, they said it should not be under deck. Why? You need a mechanical ventilation because they were not aware that we had mechanical ventilation. So I said, we have mechanical ventilation. So, okay. Understood. So there are requirements. Then there are requirements, direction of flow. Like there are cargoes which produce hydrogen and all as a gas. And they release hydrogen. Now if you allow hydrogen to come in contact with electric motor, it will be spark and it will catch fire. So there you have to supply air and allow natural exhaust. Otherwise, normally you use mechanical fans for exhaust and allow natural intake. Then every ventilator has got a closing arrangement. This one has got this arrangement. These fans, when they are fixed up, see there is a flap here on sides. You can't see all of them, but there are flaps here. Which you can open and close. So when you close it, you close it. Even these ventilators had arrangement. This one has arrangement to close it from top by turning this wheel. And these old fashioned ventilators, we used to put a wooden thing here and put a canvas lid and tight. That is how we used to close. But the major difference in ventilators and air pipes. Air pipes supply only to tanks which carry liquids. Air pipe cannot be closed. You cannot close an air pipe. Ventilators' purpose is different. Ventilators are not for breathing, like air pipes are for breathing of the tank to make sure that the inside pressure and atmospheric pressure remains the same. That is the purpose of air pipes. Ventilators, that is not the purpose. Ventilators are for removing heat, cold, odor, toxic gases, etc. Ventilators can be closed. All ventilators can be closed, whether it's a natural ventilator or mechanical ventilator. If there are small ventilators like this type, okay, they look like air pipes, but they are not air pipes. They are like gooseneck, what we say, like this. So it is shaped like this. That is gooseneck ventilators. They will have a small flap which you close and tighten up with the butterfly nut. So ventilator, each and every ventilator can be closed. Air pipe cannot be closed because air pipe is for breathing. Ventilators are to, you know, they are to be operated as per our wish. I ventilate, I don't ventilate, depending on the cargo. I do not want damage because one of the most important things is humidity and condensation. That condensation caused by humidity is called sweating. And there are two types of sweats, you know, the cargo sweat and the ship sweat. Cargo sweat means the water vapor condenses on top of cargo. That is cargo sweat. And when the water vapor condenses on the ship side, because the ship side gets too cold, that is called ship sweat. What happens is upper part of the ship is exposed to the wind, right? And air temperatures can vary drastically. Water temperatures don't vary drastically. So the upper part might get cool. Then hatch cover. Hatch cover is closed. It's metal. Suppose if you've got very cold things here, there will be condensation and water will start dripping down. That is ship sweat. If cargo is very cold and you allow warm air with moisture, and there is something called dew point. Okay, which you all are aware of dew point, but you will study it later on in meteorology. The dew point temperature, once it is breached, then water starts becoming liquid. The water vapor becomes liquid and that starts dripping and damaging the cargo. So that is very important aspect for our ventilation. We monitor it, what is outside humidity, inside humidity, temperatures and all we monitor. And we ventilate accordingly. So I have option of opening and closing ventilators, how much to open. Mechanical ventilators, when to run them, when to stop them. It is option is given to me to avoid damages. Similarly, the ventilation of accommodation is also decided by normally chief engineer. What is the temperature in the TK? What is the humidity? Then, you know, there is the option of putting on closed circulation. That means it circulates inside. But when it circulates inside, slowly oxygen will start dropping. So somebody has to take a decision how much outside air will allow. Then they open percentage wise the flaps. So much of outside air, like cars. Car air conditioning is how. Either you allow outside one or you close it. Close the flap, then you have got only internal circulation. Same thing is done here. Accommodation. Now, most important is you must be able to differentiate between air pipes and ventilators. Ventilators have got variety of requirements, you know, because it is in our control. How many times the air change? Mechanical ventilators always come with a tag. How many times in 1 hour you can change the air of the full compartment? It varies between 6 to 20 times per hour. 20 times is for a tanker's pump room. 20 times per hour, that means every 3 minutes. Every 3 minutes, you have got a full air change. That is because of hydrocarbon gases. 6 times is the minimum requirement for ro-ro ships and all. Where? The cars are driving in, there are exhaust gases, you don't want it. It is like a parking lot or a congested street. You are breathing, so that's why you have got a ventilation arrangement. Air pipes are never mechanical. Air pipes are always natural. There is no mechanical thing in air pipes. Air pipes do not support compartments. Air pipes are only for tanks carrying liquids. Rest of the places, you don't have air pipes, you got ventilators. Cofferdams will have a ventilator. Void spaces will have a ventilator. They may be small ones, like small pipe, but they are ventilators. Holds will have ventilators. Mast houses, deck houses will have some sort of arrangement to ventilate. So every compartment on a ship is ventilated. Every compartment. And every tank has got air pipes. Every tank. There is no tank without air pipes. There will be some sort of arrangement for breathing. Now we come to tankers, which is not on this page. Tankers carry oil as a cargo, and their cargo compartments are tanks. So they have got arrangement for ventilation, not ventilation, the breathing arrangement, air pipes. But there the air pipes are not like our normal air pipes, which are independent. There are two air pipes, forward one is independent of the aft one. No. On tankers, all the air pipes are merged into one, and then they are taken at a certain specific height, more than 6 meters, on mast risers. They are called mast risers. So that this is climbing up more than 6 meters, and that is where release is possible. Because when you carry oil as a cargo, you do get severe problems of, if the temperature drops, it contracts. So you need to replace some, you need to add some air. Now you don't want air to get added up because of oxygen content and mixing it up with the hydrocarbon gases. So what you generally do is, you have got an inert gas plant. So you add from there. Moment you realize there is a vacuum forming, you release inert gas so that they are maintained at about 1.1 atmospheric pressure. So they are maintained at positive pressure. So outside air can never go in, it will always go out. Similarly, ship's engine room is also maintained at pressure. So every time you open the door, you will find something blasting you on face, engine room doors. Anyway, coming back to tankers. Now what happens, other way around things happen. Other way around means there is no vacuum, but oil has got little heated up, and now there is an extra pressure in the tank. That pressure is released through automatic valve system, through the mast risers. There is a mast in the middle and the air pipes go there, and there it is released at a height of more than 6 meters at a gas release velocity of 30 meters per second. That is the minimum velocity requirement. So you have air pipes on tankers, but they are not left free like ballast tanks or other like fuel oil tanks. They are under a controlled system. They are designed to be controlled in a specific manner to maintain positive pressure in the tanks. Is it clear? Huh? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Somebody to say yes at least. Huh? Understood or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can differentiate between air pipe and the ventilator?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, this is what is important, so that you don't get mixed up. You will forget one or two points right now. Nothing abnormal about it. But over a period, you must know what is air pipe, what is ventilator. But both the systems have got certain common things, but purposes are different. Air pipes, the purpose is not to allow any built up or vacuum in the tank. buildup of pressure or vacuum in a tank carrying liquids under any circumstances. Ventilators is something else. Ventilators is something that is controlled because there is a purpose behind it. We don't want to damage cargo due to humidity. You don't want to damage cargo because it is excessively smelly or something. Then you know, it's a planned activity when you ventilate. The air pipes activity is not planned. It is automatic. And air pipes on tankers, it is monitored all the time so that if there is a vacuum condition, you release the inert gas. If it is extra pressure, it is released in a specific way, that is 30 meters per second velocity at a height of more than 6 meters in atmosphere, so that the hydrocarbon gases which are there, inflammable gases, will not catch fire. That is the reason it is different. Its sizes vary according to the ship. You know, some will have smaller ones, some will have bigger ones, and also on. Follow. Anything more? Any questions? Why no questions? Any questions, brothers?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No.
No doubt, sir.
I did not say sisters.